Morning girls, so welcome back to another important lecture on physics first year. So today we are going to deal with a very important aspect, with a very fundamental aspect, mathematical tools to understand physics. So today we are going to deal with a very important topic, a very fundamental topic everybody is supposed to know, might be MPC or maybe BPC, everybody is supposed to know. So what are the mathematical tools in order to understand physics very well? So the first thing we got, will be generally called trigonometric functions. So the first thing we got, will be generally called trigonometric functions. So you already know under trigonometrical functions. Now the first thing, you already got a right angle triangle. Now let's say this angle will be theta. So from the right angle triangle, I can write down what will be sine theta. You already know sine theta will always be defined opposite by hypotenuse. So sine theta will be numerically equal to opposite divided by hypotenuse, that will be numerically equal to from the diagram y divided by r. So that will be numerically equal to y by r. Then similarly, the second trigonometric function we got, that will be cos theta, and cos theta will always be defined adjacent divided by hypotenuse. So cos theta can be written adjacent divided by hypotenuse. So that will be numerically equal to x divided by r. So this will be numerically equal to x divided by r. Now similarly, the third trigonometric function we got, that will be tan theta, and tan theta will always be defined opposite divided by adjacent. So you already know tan theta will be numerically equal to opposite divided by adjacent. That will be numerically equal to y divided by x. So tan theta will be numerically equal to opposite divided by adjacent. That will be numerically equal to y divided by x. Then similarly, if I remove the diagram, similarly the other trigonometric functions we got, the fourth one, that will be cot theta, and you already know cot theta will be numerically equal to reciprocal of tan theta. That will be numerically equal to 1 divided by y by x. That will become x divided by y. Similarly, the next trigonometric function we got, that will be sec theta, and you already know sec theta will be numerically equal to 1 by cos theta. So cos theta will be x by r. This will become r divided by x. So 1 by
cos theta. So 1 r divided by x by r. Now that will become now r divided by x. Now similarly, now the last trigonometric function we got, now that will be cos theta, that will be numerically equal to now 1 by sin theta. Now that will be numerically equal to now 1 by y by r. Now that is going to become now r divided by y. So remember, now these are called now the trigonometric functions, or these are the basic building blocks in order to understand physics. Now even the people for the second year who are going to appear for NEET, for IIT, for JEE mains, for MCET, I recommend all the people, not only first year, even all the second year people should know now what will be the basic mathematical tools that will be required in order to understand the physics. So now that will be the first thing we got. So that is what we call now the trigonometric functions. Similarly, the next important thing, now or rather a very very important thing. So now remember, now the next important thing that will be generally called, now the next important thing, now that will be generally called now trigonometric ratio. So now let us see now one more important thing, now that will be generally called now trigonometric ratio. Or let us see now the second fundamental thing, now that will be generally called the trigonometric ratio. So what do you mean by that? So if I make the tabular column, now the first thing we got now sin theta, now the second one will be cos theta, and the third one will be tan theta. So what I will do, so now what I will do, now we are finding out now what are the different values of theta. So 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, 120 degree, followed by now we got 135 degree, now followed by we got 150 degree, now followed by 180 degree, now followed by 360 degree. So let us find out now what will be the values of all the trigonometric functions for the different values of theta. Or let us find out now what will be the values of sin theta, cos theta, and tan theta for the different values of theta. So first we got 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, 120 degree, 135 degree, 150 degree, 180 degree, and 360 degree. Now remember, now sine, now this will be what we call the angle. So now remember, now sine 0 degree will be numerically equal to 0. Now sine 30 degree will be numerically equal to 1 by 2. Now sine 45 degree will be numerically equal to 1 by root 2, sin 60 degree will be numerically equal to root 3 by 2, now sin 90 degree will be numerically equal to 1, now sin 120 degree will be numerically equal to sin 90 plus 30 degree, that will be cos 30 degree, now that will be numerically equal to root 3 divided by 2. Now similarly, now sin 135 degree will be sin 90 plus 45 degree, that will be cos 45 degree, that will be equal to 1 by root 2. Now sin 150 degree will be sin 90 plus 60 degree, that will be cos 60 degree, that will be equal to 1 by 2. Now sin 180 degree will be 0, sin 360 degree will also be equal to 0. So remember, now that will be the values of sin, or that will be the values of sin for the different angles. Now similarly, now let us see now what are the values of cos theta. So remember, cos 0 degree will be numerically equal to 1, cos 30 degree will be numerically equal to root 3 by 2. So cos 30 degree will be numerically equal to root 3 by 2, cos 45 degree will be numerically equal to 1 by root 2, cos 60 degree will be numerically equal to 1 by 2, cos 90 degree will be 0, cos 120 degree will be minus 1 by 2, cos 135 degree will be cos 90 plus 45 degree, that will be minus sin 45, that will be equal to minus 1 by root 2. Now cos 150 degree, now cos 90 plus 60, now that will be now minus sin 60 degree, now that will be now minus root 3 by 2. Now similarly, cos 180 degree will be minus 1, and cos 360 degree will be equal to plus 1. So now, if you come to the last thing, now let us see now what will be the values of tan theta, or let us see now what will be the values we got for tan theta. So tan 0 degree will be 0, now tan 30 degree will be 1 by root 3, now tan 45 degree will be 1, now tan 60 degree will be root 3, tan 90 degree will be infinity, now tan 120 degree, so if you divide both of them, now what we are going to get, now minus root 3, now tan 135 degree will be numerically equal to minus 1, now tan 150 degree, now what we are going to get, now minus 1 by root 3, now tan 180 degree will be 0, and tan 360 degree will also be equal to 0. So remember, now that will be the values we got, or that will be now generally called the trigonometric ratio. So you are supposed to know now what are the values of sin theta, cos theta, and tan theta for the different values of angle ranging from now 0 degree to 360 degree. Now remember everybody, now whether maybe by PC first year or maybe MPC first year or even the second year people, MPC and by PC, you are supposed to know the fundamental mathematics that will be required in order to tackle even the competitive exams like JEE, mains, NEET or advanced, BITSAT, even MSAT. All the competitive exams will be requiring the knowledge of these mathematical tools to understand physics very well. So that will be another important topic we got, so called the trigonometric ratio. Now once you are thorough with this table, or once you are familiar with this table, now let's come to now another very very important thing. Now proceeding with the same trigonometry, now let us come to now another important thing. This will be given in most of the numerical problems in physics. Now always remember, it's a very very important thing that will be given in most of the numerical problems, and one has to remember now what will be the value of cos 37 degree. So remember, now cos 37 degree will be numerically equal to 4 by 5. That's the reason why now what I will do, if I draw the right angle triangle, now this angle will be 37 degree. So cos 37 will be adjacent, now divided by hypotenuse, so opposite will be equal to 3. So now from the given triangle, now I can find out now what will be the value of sine 37 degree, that will be numerically equal to now opposite by hypotenuse. So sine 37 will be numerically equal to 3 by 5. Now similarly, now I can write now tan 37 degree will be numerically equal to now opposite divided by adjacent. So tan 37 degree will be numerically equal to 3 by 4. So remember, now this will be now another important thing you need to remember now regarding the angle 37 degree. So most of the competitive exams, all India level exams, they will be giving 37 degree. So you should know what is the value of cos 37. So cos 37 will be numerically equal to 4 by 5. That's the reason why sine 37 will be numerically equal to 3 by 5 and tan 37 degree will be numerically equal to 3 by 4. Now similarly, now remember, now one more important thing, now that will be, now what will be the value of cos 53 degree. Now remember, the value of cos 53 degree will be numerically equal to 3 by 5. So therefore, now once again, if I draw the right angle triangle, now this angle will be 53 degree. So cos 53 degree will be 3 by 5, this will be 3, this will be 5, so opposite will be equal to 4. So I can find out now what will be the value of sine of 53 degree. So therefore, now sine of 53 degree will be numerically equal to opposite by hypotenuse, that will be numerically equal to 4 by 5. And similarly, now tan 53 degree will be numerically equal to now opposite divided by adjacent, now that will be numerically equal to now 4 divided by 3. So now that will be now one more important thing you need to remember now about the angle now cos 37 degree and what is the value of sine what is the value of cos 37 degree and what is the value of cos 53 degree. So remember now one more very important thing now regarding the angle 37 and 53. So then now once you are familiar with this thing, now let us come to now one more important thing. So now let us come to now one more important thing, so that will be generally called. So now let us come to now one more important thing, now that will be generally called now trigonometric formulae. So now coming on to now one more important thing, now that will be generally called now trigonometric formulae. Now let us see now what are the trigonometric formulas they got, or what are the trigonometric formulas we got. So now remember the first formula we got, now that will be called now sine of a plus b. So remember now sine of a plus b will be numerically equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. So now remember the first important formula, now sine of a plus b will be numerically equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. Now similarly, now let us come to now another important formula, now that will be now sine of a minus b. Now remember, now sine of a minus b will be numerically equal to now sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. So one more important formula we got, now sine. So one more important formula we got, so sine of a minus b will be numerically equal to sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. Now similarly, now one more important formula you got, the third one, now that will be generally called now cos of a plus b. And remember, now cos of a plus b will be numerically equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So one more important formula, now remember, now cos of a plus b will be numerically equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Now similarly, the fourth important formula we got, now that will be now cos of A minus B, that will be numerically equal to, now we got cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So now one more important formula you got. So cos of A minus B will be numerically equal to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So remember, now these are the important formulas you need to remember under trigonometry. Very important formulas. Now as far as the physics is concerned, from the perspective of physics, it will be very important formulas they got under trigonometry. Then apart from that, now you also know now one more formula. Now you also know now sine square theta plus cos square theta will be numerically equal to 1. So you are already familiar the important identity. Now sine square theta plus cos square theta will be numerically equal to 1. So now what we'll do? Now further we'll proceed and let us see now what further we are going to get. Now once you are thorough with all these things, or once you have noted all these important things, now let us come to now one more important thing, or let us come to now one more important thing. So now what I am going to do, so now I am going to take a special case. Now let us see, if A will be numerically equal to B, so in the above formula, now what I am doing, I am taking a special case. If A will be numerically equal to B, now meaning what? Now wherever we got B, or remember, now wherever we got B, now B will be replaced by A. So I'm applying the case here. So A will be numerically equal to B, or wherever we got B, so B can be replaced by A. So therefore, now what I am going to get now, I can write now capital A plus now B will be numerically equal to A. So wherever we got B, now B will be numerically equal to A. So what we get, now sine of A plus A will be numerically equal to, now wherever you got B, now B will be replaced by A. So what you are going to get, so sine A, so we get cos A plus we get cos A, now multiplied by, now we get sin A. So therefore, now what will happen, now A plus A will become 2A, or A plus A will become 2A. That's the reason why we are getting another formula. So sin 2A will be numerically equal to, now what I get, now sin A cos A, sin A cos A plus sin A cos A. So therefore, now what I am going to get, so I am going to get now another important formula. So sin 2A will be numerically equal to, now what I am going to get, now sin A cos A plus sin a cos a is going to become so 2 sin a into cos a. So remember, now this is going to become the formula for sin 2a. Now another very important trigonometric formula. So remember the formula. So sin 2a will be numerically equal to 2 sin a into cos a, or sin 2a will be numerically equal to 2 sin a into cos a. So that will be, now one more important formula we got under trigonometry, a very important thing you are going to see in the upcoming chapters. Now how important this mathematical tools are going to play the vital role in order to understand the physics. So that will be now another important formula we got. So now let us see now one more important thing. So now let us see now one more important thing. So now what I will do, now I will take the formula for cos of a plus b. So you are already familiar with this formula. So you are already familiar with this formula. Now cos of a plus b will be numerically equal to, now we got now cos a into cos b minus sin a into sin b. So just now I told you the formula. Now cos of a plus b will be numerically equal to cos a into cos b minus sin a into sin b. Now once again, now what I am doing, so once again I am taking a special case. Now if a will be numerically equal to b, now let us see now what is going to happen if a will be numerically equal to b. Now meaning, now wherever you got b, now replace with a. So therefore, now what you get, so cos of a plus a will be numerically equal to, now what we are going to get, now cos a into cos a minus sin a into sin a. So what we are going to get, so we are going to get now another important formula. So cos 2a will be numerically equal to now cos square a minus sin square a. So remember, now one more important formula we are going to derive here. So cos 2a will be numerically equal to now cos square a minus sin square a. So that will be now another important formula we got. So cos 2a will be numerically equal to, so we got now cos square a minus sin square a. Now can we further simplify? So we can further simplify. Now let us see now how to write further, or how to simplify further this formula. So now what I will do, now further, now you already know this identity, now sin square a plus plus cos square a will be numerically equal to 1. So therefore, from here now I can write, now sin square a will be numerically equal to now 1 minus cos square a. So what I am going to do, now wherever we got now sin square a or wherever we got, now sin square a that can be replaced by now 1 minus cos square a. So therefore, now what we are going to get, so cos 2a will be numerically equal to now cos square a minus of now sin square a will be now 1 minus cos square a. So if you open the bracket, now what you are going to get, so if you open the bracket, so cos 2a will be numerically equal to now cos square a now minus 1, now minus into minus will be plus, now plus cos square a. So therefore, now what you are going to get, so cos 2a will be numerically equal to now what we are getting, now 2 cos square a minus 1, or what I will do, I will take minus 1 this side. So what we are going to get, now 1 plus cos 2a will be numerically equal to now 2 cos square a. So therefore, I can find out now what will be the value of cos square a. So therefore, now cos square a now will be numerically equal to now what I am going to get, now 1 plus cos 2a now divided by 2. So therefore, so I am getting the value of cos square a. So cos square a will be numerically equal to now 1 plus cos 2a now divided by 2. So remember, now that will be the value we got for cos square a. So cos square a will be numerically equal to now 1 plus cos 2a now divided by 2. Now once you are familiar with this formula, now further we can simplify, or further you can remember now one more important thing. Now further you can remember now one more important thing. Now from this identity, now what I will do, so now I will find out now what will be the value of cos square a. So cos square a will be numerically equal to now 1 minus sin square a. Now that I am going to substitute in the formula for cos 2a that will be given by now cos square a minus sin square a. So what I will do, now wherever we got now cos square a, or wherever we got now cos square a, that will be numerically equal to 1 minus sin square a. So therefore, now what I am going to get, so cos 2a will be numerically equal to now 1 minus sin square a minus sin square a. So further, if I simplify, so what you are going to get, so cos 2a will be numerically equal to 1 minus 2 sin square a. Now you take now minus 2 sin square a now this side, and cos 2a on the other side. Now what I am doing, I am rearranging the formula, now take minus 2 sin square a on the left hand side and cos 2a on the right hand side. So therefore, now what I am going to get? So I get not 2 sin square a will be numerically equal to, now what I get? Now 1 minus cos 2a. So from here I can find the value of sin square a. So therefore, now sin square a will be numerically equal to, now what I am going to get? Now 1 minus cos 2a, now whole divided by 2. So remember, now this will be, the value we got for the sin square a. So sin square a will be numerically equal to, now 1 minus cos 2a divided by 2. So remember, now that will be the formulas we got. So remember, now cos square a will be numerically equal to 1 plus cos 2a divided by 2. Similarly, now sin square a will be numerically equal to 1 minus cos 2a now divided by 2. So now, once you are thorough with this particular consonant, now remember, now one more important thing. So now, remember, when theta is very small, then sin theta will be approximately equal to theta. Similarly, now tan theta will be approximately equal to theta. Now implies what? Now sin theta will be approximately equal to tan theta, or I can write, now sin theta will be approximately equal to, now tan theta can be written, now sin theta divided by cos theta. So sin theta will be getting cancelled. So now what you do? Now you cross multiply. So what you get? So cos theta will be approximately equal to 1. So remember this important concept, now whenever theta is very small, or whenever the angle theta is very small, then sin theta will be approximately equal to theta. Tan theta will be approximately equal to theta, implies sin theta will be approximately equal to tan theta. So tan theta can be written sin theta by cos theta. So sin and sin cancel, now implies now cos theta will be approximately equal to 1. So remember, now that will be another important thing you need to remember. Then once you are familiar with this thing, now remember one more important thing. Now remember, now one more important thing for the adult self. So now remember one more important thing. So now remember now another important thing. Now remember now sign of minus theta will always be equal to minus sine theta. Similarly, now remember now cos of minus theta will be numerically equal to plus cos theta, and tan of minus theta will be numerically equal to now minus tan theta. So remember, now this will be now one more very important thing you need to remember under trigonometry. Now sine of minus theta will be numerically equal to minus sine theta. Cos of minus theta will be numerically equal to plus cos theta, and tan of minus theta will be numerically equal to minus tan theta. So remember, now that was a very important thing. That's a very important fundamental thing, the important mathematical tools to understand physics. So remember, is only part one, and part two is going to come very soon. So if you are thorough with all the mathematics